Episode 1512, Find the Beauty in the Mundane.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive. Happy every day. It is Saturday. That means it's Relationship Builders Day. Are you ready to put your marriage first? Are you ready to decide that building a strong foundation is exactly what you need? It's time to find the beauty in the mundane. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, how much of your day focuses on daily responsibilities, the stuff you just do because, well, you have to? Find the beauty in the mundane. It's the little things in life that impact your day. Same goes for your marriage. Your marriage is shaped by the little things, which all adds up to the bigger things. But for some reason, we rationalize that it's the bigger things causing us grief, frustration, despair, and disappointment. If you think specifically about situations that come up in your marriage, like disagreements of plans, maybe arguments regarding money, frustrations of attention, very rarely does it involve something huge like buying a car or a house on a whim. You don't go out and buy those things on a whim. It's more about the little things. It's the little things that comprise more than 15 hours on average of our focus. Crazy? Yes, but supposedly it's true, because at the Bureau of Labor and Statistics, it was released in June of 2018, it comprised these average of hours that we spend doing certain activities. And so you add up what we do on just the daily mundane responsibilities, and it's more than 15 hours. That's crazy. But wrapped in those little things are blessings in disguise. After a long day of work, you have the privilege of coming home to a place that you call home. It's not just a house. Now, it may not have everything in its proper place. Dishes may greet you in the kitchen, but there's blessings there. You found food, right? You have food, yet it is a home. Toys all over the house. Well, if you have children or a dog, you got toys all over the house. But guess what? You get to enjoy their smiling faces. You get to enjoy their wagging tails. And what about the clothes and shoes everywhere, especially the bedroom? It looks like when you walk in, if you haven't had a teenager, well, just wait. But for some reason, they explode. And even when they turn into an adult, my daughter's visiting this weekend, it's like she's entered the room and all of a sudden it's everywhere. Well, guess what? You can afford to have more than just one pair of shoes and one pair of jeans. The blessings in the little things. The blessings in disguise. We can let ourselves get pulled in by what we think our everyday is supposed to look like. But in real life, no matter how much we want it a certain way, well, the day never lives up to that way. We try to make it something that it usually isn't. So instead of becoming exasperated with your spouse or frustrated with your children, or maybe you want to send the dog to the doghouse, think again. Find the beauty in the mundane. That is your Kiss the Keep It Simple strategy. Find the beauty in the mundane. You know, the beauty of paying bills is incredible. Having the ability to pay the bill, even if only a little bit, it's a blessing. Maybe we don't want to really pay the bills. It is a pain, but guess what? You have the opportunity to be able to pay the bills. There are a lot of people in much worse situations. The beauty of dirty laundry overflowing the dirty clothes basket means you have clothes that you can afford and you can enjoy wearing. And we can't leave out all the little things our spouses do that gets under our nerves. Oh my gosh, leaving the toilet lit up, seriously? Well, at least he goes to the bathroom on his own. That's a blessing, just saying. Maybe his specific morning routine. He has to have things in a certain order, and he does it all the time. I mean, if he wasn't getting up that morning, you could literally write, at 6:06, he does this. At 6:10, 1.5 seconds into it, he will do this. Okay, it may drive you crazy initially because, you know, when something goes wrong in that morning routine, it's like the earth has shaken. Well, guess what? At least he knows what he wants. That's a positive. And you know what? Maybe how food is chewed. Have you ever sat there going, gosh, they chew like a cow? And it doesn't even have to be your spouse. Okay, maybe it is your spouse. It could be your child, or it could be just your good friend, whatever it is. And all of a sudden you're noticing, gosh, just the way they chew is really kind of weird. But guess what? At least they can actually chew their food. You don't have to make homemade baby food in order to feed them. That's a blessing. Maybe something that gets under your nerves is a filing system. Mm-hmm. Think back to the bills. And you have to pay the bills. You have to find the bills. Well, maybe you don't like the filing system, but at least there is a system and he'll file it for you. So maybe it doesn't really fit into how you want things done, but there is a system. There's beauty in the mundane. Find that beauty. The less exciting, the less interesting, but when we look for that beauty, it changes how we see our day to day. I think we try to make our day to day bigger than what it really is. Because really what God wants us to see is the beauty in the mundane. The stuff that's there because, well, we have to look for that beauty. What if you were walking a dirty road with just sandals on, going from one town to the next, and at the previous town, you were just spit on, yelled at, and then maybe you decided that you would take another path and somebody found you and said, oh, but wait, you are the Son of God. I want to listen to you. You have value. You bring worth. And then you turn another corner and all of a sudden you're spit upon. It's the little things that Jesus experienced as he walked the roads daily. It's a lesson for us, the beauty in the mundane. So what does that look like to walk those roads? How can you find the beauty in the mundane? Well, number one, you have to acknowledge the good in the little things. Just like we gave examples of, right? The toilet lit up. Seriously? Well, you could be changing his pants. Just saying. I know. Come on. It puts a little smile on your face. You're like, okay, maybe if I look at the toilet lid like that, maybe I can chuckle. Well, if that's what you need, then find those blessings. Because ultimately, sometimes we've got the craziest things too. If he was to make a list of you, what would he make? Kind of scary thought. So acknowledge the good in the little things. Number two, seek the blessings in the mess. Life is messy, but I promise you, you can find some sprinkles of goodness along the way. Those blessings, the mess that you're in, find it, look for it. I can remember some crazy situations in my lifetime, but somehow, some way, I sought out the blessings and I didn't actually see the mess, the beauty in the mundane. And finally, number three, know nothing crumbles overnight. We live our life to achieve something and not just achieve once a quarter, once a semester, once a season. We want to achieve something on a daily basis. Our culture demands it of us almost to the point that it just kind of sits at us and we're always getting this nudge from the world. Whether you're going through your Facebook feed, whether you're seeing things on Instagram, whatever it is, you're watching Netflix or Hulu, maybe you're at the movie theater because you still like to see movies the old-fashioned way with a tub of greasy, yummy, buttery popcorn and your family yelling in a theater. How fun is that? But it's those commercials that say, you don't add up to anything if you don't achieve this. What is your big achievement today? Because otherwise you're nothing. That's not the case. No, nothing crumbles overnight. It's the little things. Find the beauty in the mundane. You're not going to have the answers to everything, but you can seek the blessings in the mess. You can acknowledge the good in the little things. And you can know that as you walk your journey, that nothing's going to crumble overnight, that God's got you. So what worries you today in your relationship? What has you overthinking all this stuff in your life? What is it that you're sitting there every single day just harping on your spouse? That's probably a lot to do with the little things. Think about it. The next time you go to have a disagreement, the next time you go and you have an argument, the next time you go and there's something else that says, you know what? I just want more attention. What is it about that situation? If you stop long enough quickly, you'll see that you're in the middle of a little thing. It's not something huge. But we make it huge, don't we? Because it's the little things that matter. So as you go through your day, I really want you to be aware of the little things. What happens this morning at the breakfast table? If you haven't had breakfast already. Now, if you had, pay attention tomorrow. Maybe tonight at dinner, what does it look like? If you're out and about on your way to the movies, look, pay attention. What are those little things? Maybe there's a comment that he always says to you and you're like, oh gosh, I just wish he wouldn't say that. Well, then look for something precious in what he does say and find the good in the little things. When you begin to change your perspective, when you begin to look at things with the ask, look, which is the acknowledge, seek, and know, you're creating what? Curiosity. Curiosity, well, it takes you back to what? Your dating years. That curiosity, what? Usually draws you closer. You got to have that in your marriage. Build that strong foundation. It all starts with the beauty in the mundane. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.